Let's look at the competition between SN2, E2, SN1, and E1 reactions, and also the stereochemistry of each reaction. So the SN2 process competes only with the E2 reaction, and it's favored by a primary electrophile, but also a secondary is okay. All right, and so we'll look at one of those in just a second. Also, the SN2 is favored by a strong nucleophile, and a weak base. Strong nucleophile and a weak base to discourage E2 competition. So let's look at the mechanism. Well, suppose we have a chiral system like 2-bromobutane. Well, mechanistically, if we have a nucleophile, so this would be a secondary electrophile on this carbon because it has two R groups attached. A primary would be most beneficial, but let's have a look at the secondary to illustrate stereochemistry. And let's use a weak base, but a pretty good nucleophile in acetate. And so if we perform this reaction, we're going to go through a transition state that is planar. So the best I can do to draw that. And we're going to have a partial bond forming between the nucleophile, acetate, and we're going to have a bond partially breaking between the leaving group, bromine. So if we draw this in a manner that lines everything up. Okay, so what we've done is we've matched up all of our groups and the hydrogen is left over. Okay, and we've lined up the stereochemistry. We show this transition state. And here a delta minus is forming on the bromine. There's a delta minus here on the nucleophile. So we're showing the stereochemistry is inverted in our final product. We're actually going to end up with acetate on the inverted position, okay, relative to the original group. And this is 100% inversion for the stereochemistry of an SN2 reaction. For an E2 reaction, it competes with SN2, E1, and SN1. Okay, so it's in competition with all three. It will be favored by a strong base and a weak nucleophile. But this strong base trumps E1 and SN1 because it takes so long to form a carbocation with E1 and SN1, as we'll see, that if we have a strong base, such as a charged base, okay, and they'll be in competition with SN2 by the factors that we've saw, but a weak nucleophile might be a bulky base. And so we can compete against SN2 using one of these bulky bases like potassium tert butoxide, so potassium counter ion to tert butoxide, or DBU and DBN, or any number of the bulky proton sponging bases. Okay, and so we favor E2 over SN2 by weakening the strength of the nucleophile relative to the base strength. And mechanistically, if we look at this, E2 is a concerted anti-nucleophilic periplanar elimination. So it happens all in one step, and we have to eliminate from a particular conformation. And so we're going to show bonds breaking and bonds leaving. So if we take the Newman projection and we take the, let's name this accordingly to minimize the group number, and so if we put the numbers we get a 2-3. Well, let's look down the 2-3 bond with our Newman projection. So anything intersecting my green circle there is going to go on the Newman projection. Anything left over is a hydrogen. And so if we rotate everything to the proper angle, build a model if it's hard to see this, on carbon 2 in the front we would have bromine up, hydrogen to the right, methyl to the left. And we can kind of see that if we draw in our hydrogen. And what if we draw in our hydrogen here on the back carbon? Well, we need the hydrogen down. We know that has to be the case for an anti-periplanar elimination. We eliminate beta hydrogens. And we favor regiochemistry, the Zaitsev or more substituted alkene product. Okay, and so to do that, we can't eliminate from the beta hydrogens on carbon 1, or we would end up with a less substituted alkene. So we want to end up with the double bond in that position. And so let's look at this elimination on the Newman projection, anti-periplanar stereochemistry. And so the way we've got it drawn, that would mean the ethyl group is to the right, and then the methyl is to the left. So I can again write the symbols instead of the carbons just to keep everything together. And so since the elimination has to occur in this manner, everything's got to be anti-relationship in the same plane. So we're in the same plane here, and we are anti-configuration. This elimination occurs through the transition state where this bond lengthens and breaks, and this bond lengthens and breaks. So the base, whatever that may be, comes in, grabs the proton, and eliminates. And so let's show that forming a bond between the base and the hydrogen breaking and the bromine bond breaking, and a bond forming for the double bond. Let's go back and show the full mechanism here from our original representation. And we can draw this anti-periplanar like we did a moment ago. Have our base, whatever it may be, proton is abstracted or removed, deprotonated, double bond forms, leaving group leaves, all in one step. Okay, so most mechanisms will not be required to show this transition state, but these are the mechanistic arrows that we would show. And the reason I recommend drawing the transition state is because you can see what goes together on each side of the double bond from this representation. We flatten everything out, and we put methyls on the same side, and we put the ethyl group with the hydrogen that's not drawn in a skeletal structure. If we name this E and Z, high versus low, low and high, we end up with the E isomer. Only the E isomer, because we only had one beta hydrogen for the Zaitsev product. Okay, so this is a stereospecific concerted anti-periplanar elimination. And if we'd had a different, if we'd had different stereochemistry in the starting material, we could have gotten a different product. We could have gotten the Z with different stereochemistry in the starting material. Now, if we look at a ring type elimination, remember anti-periplanar is required, and so in the equatorial position, the leaving group is equatorial here and thus is unable to participate in elimination reaction via E2. So we have to ring flip, putting bromine axial down, and as we ring flip, we put our methyl here axial up, and notice how now our beta hydrogen is equatorial. So this cannot participate either. So leaving group equatorial and hydrogen equatorial, so we can't make a true Zaitsev product. We have to do an elimination from the axial hydrogen. Let me redraw the methyl here to get it out of the way. We have to do our elimination from the axial hydrogen next door. So our base, preferably a bulky base, weak nucleophile, accomplishes the elimination from anti-periplanar relationship. And if we keep everything lined up, we end up with this product, which if we draw in a planar configuration, would look like this.